Hey guys, and welcome back to another train simulator video on the Chiltern Main Line. Today we're going to be working on a service from Birmingham New Street to Southampton. Please work southwards and follow the signals. Your first stop will be Leamington or Lermington Spa, 6:57 to 7 o'clock. So we're going to be stopping at that station and Banbury Platform 3. Drive a Voyager from Small Heath to Banbury whilst working this, I'm guessing, route or service of the day. We are driving a class 220 from Just Train, so let's put the master key in. Put into neutral. There you go. I'm going to put into 4 now anyway. Take the DI off. We can play this, the radio message. There you go.
Welcome to the
lights. There you go.
And now in radio test.
I think we can go now, so. So going. I'm not too sure where we are on the route, but I might have to check the map. I'm guessing towards this side is Birmingham New Street, I'm guessing. Let me check. So we're all the way there, yeah. So basically we've just came from Birmingham New Street and I'm going to be going towards Southampton Central, I'm guessing. But we are going to be stopping at Banbury, where another driver will take over and take the train to Southampton Central. As obviously that route isn't in the game, Birmingham New Street to Southampton Central, but that would be cool to drive the full length of the journey, but oh well. What can you do? At least we're driving with class 220 Voyager. And not class 166 or 165 on this route, which is really slow. And it is from Just Trains as well, so the cab looks really nice. On the clipboard light if you want. Get on this I think as well. Yep. Why not? What else can we do here? I don't think anything else works. Oh, don't speed. Now, I have already done a scenario on this Chiltern Main Line between London, Marylebone and Beechester Village, so if you haven't checked that out, go check it out first if you're more interested in that part of the route, and of course the S8 Stock Metropolitan Line, which I'm really excited for. But in this scenario, we're going to be playing around the Birmingham end of the route between Birmingham and Banbury. What station is this? I have no idea. Tisley or something? I saw. But yeah, we are doing cross-country service. Let me show you the passenger view for this train, which is very nice as well. Probably one of the best trains that Just Trains have made. This is coach C. We should hear one of these people phone go on or start sneezing or something. If you wait enough in the thing. There you go, he just coughed. Station is that? No idea. This part of the Chiltern Main I don't know much about, so I don't know the station off by heart. Let's pick up some speed. Nice. We've got 18 miles left to Leamington Spa. I hope I'm saying it right. There's a lot of stations on this route that I can't pronounce well, so... it's not great, is it? Okay, done the British speed limit. There we go. Then, of course, we're going to be stopping at Banbury Platform 3, which is 37 miles away. So the Chiltern Main Line is released now by Just Trains. It does cost $24.99, but you get 112 miles route. You get 14 scenarios with a bunch of trains, and you do get S8 stock Metropolitan Line as AI, so that's really nice. Now I have basically the S8 stock you can have in quick drive, but or free drive or whatever it's called, but you can't actually drive it. The whistle works for it. There is a HUD for it, but whenever you move into forward or go into braking, like, nothing happens basically. So you have a train, but which isn't controllable basically. But it is available in quick drive. So, for example, if you have the North London Line and if you want a screenshot of the S8 stock, obviously, which is pretty similar to, it's pretty much the same as the S7 stock, but it's just one less carriage difference. So you could you could go to Richmond and have an S8 stock on one of the District Line trains platforms, so take a screenshot if you want, and then you can tell your friends that the District Line train is in Train Simulator or something like that. But yeah, you can't drive the S8 stock, unfortunately, which kind of sucks. Even if you could just drive it from the exterior view, it would have been nice. I understand why they didn't do a driver's cab and a passenger one, but would have liked it to be drivable exterior view at least, or something like that. Are those the right lights? I think those are the right lights, but the lights look quite weird actually. I think we're driving just the normal Voyager, not the super one. Yeah, we're just driving the normal one. Nice cab view. It is quite laggy, this route. Should be seeing, apart from Chiltern Railways, of course. Okay, what is that? There's one. Chiltern Railways, nice. There we go. Oh, I'll be speeding. I am not paying attention, guys. That's what happens when you're exterior and you're too busy looking at other trains. You don't pay attention on the speed limit. Oh, that's a nice view. There we go. 12 miles left to Leamington Spa. Leamington Spa. I think that sounds much more better than Leamington. We've got Lapworth Platform 1 on the HUD. Nice. And if you are wondering, there is a class 68 scenario for this route. It's only one, but it's quite a good one, I think. It's between Marylebone and Banbury, I believe. It's a 77 minute scenario, so it's quite long, but it does use a Chiltern Railways livery as well. So if you have the class 68 and you want to drive it with a Chiltern Railways livery, then get this route, basically. Or you can just go on Quick Drive and you drive it from Marylebone to, I'm guessing, Birmingham Moor Street. Snow Hill, I mean. I'm guessing the maximum speed on this route is 100 miles an hour. But at least it's better than the London Brighton route, which is only 90 miles an hour, so it's better than that though. Train, I think. Yeah, we are. There we are. Four car cross country Voyager. It is quite laggy on this path of routes. I might just stay in the cab actually. Before the game decides to freeze and crashes on me. Which it might happen because this is a third party route, so the game doesn't like third party routes. So obviously they're made by different peoples and... Okay, speed limit is going down to 85 miles an hour, so let's start slowing down soon. But yeah, like, Dovetail Game is probably making it in a way that it suits the game more, I'm guessing. So it's a little bit more optimized, but... Obviously, just Trains and Armstrong Powers just makes content for the game, so... Don't expect it to run completely well. It's still gonna run well anyway, because... The engine for this game is really old and obviously all the hype is for Train Sim World, which still doesn't have any UK content available, which I'm still disappointed about. I actually got Train Sim World, but I refunded it because it wasn't really worth it in my opinion. The optimization was better, but we need to slow down. Eyes on the brakes slowing down. Oh, these brakes are not good. 6, 5, there we go. Just in time. I actually completely forgot what I was talking about, so apologies for that. I'm always going downhill. Whoops. Spa, Leamington Spa. I'm so sounding that wrong, you know. I just can't pronounce that station name. We should start slowing down actually. So the route is 6:57 and departure at 7 o'clock in the morning. This is quite an early service in the morning. What is it? The 6:31 from Birmingham New Street to Southampton Central. If anyone takes this route in real life in the morning, then let me know. That's the driver alarm, making sure that I'm awake and not falling half asleep. I mean, we should really slow down actually. Brakes on the train are not the best. Yeah, I'm not too sure why it's so laggy, because it's just scenery, you know. And it was more or smoother when I was driving from Marylebone to Wembley Stadium, that part of the route. And you would expect that part of the route to be more laggy because obviously it's between London and there's a lot of London buildings and all that. But this is just all greenery and I'm not too sure why it's lagging so much. Nice. How many miles to Banbury? Where is Banbury? There it is. 23 miles. So yeah, 20 miles, 20 miles difference between Leamington Spa and Banbury. Pretty much exactly 20 miles, so not too bad. You know what, let's play the radio again. Why not? I can. It's not working. There you go.
Welcome to the remote radio test unit. Please leave your message after the tone.
This is the NRN radio test call.
Cab lights. It's still daytime anyway, so. If we've got 40 miles an hour speed limit, then down to 30. Still seem to be picking up speed though. Is that a yellow signal? Yes it is. Yeah, we are really early anyway. Really, really early. I was a bit too late for the screenshot, so I didn't bother with it. That's my bad. Wow, the game's really lagging now though. That kind of sucks. I guess I could take a screenshot at Leamington Spa. Okay game, I know the speed limit is changing. Slowly heading to the station. We do have two tracks in the middle for services that don't stop at the station, so fast services. Nice. Well, we need to slow down actually. The station looks quite nice actually. Even though we're a couple of minutes early, that's fine. Take a look around the station. Doors. Change here for Chiltern Main Line Route services, I'm guessing. Other Voyager services. One screenshot. And this is another screenshot. Oh, that looks weird, you know, look at that. The Leamington Spa thingy is basically inside of the pole. That looks kind of funny. That is so weird. Nice. No, let's just take a screenshot of that, so why not? The rest of them are fine though. Like, this one's fine. They're all fine except that one. I'm guessing what some of their just trains should fix that. Got a bicycle rack here. Interesting. Platform 1 and 2, toilets. We've got a bar, I'm guessing. Coffee. It's closed today, unfortunately. S-car stop. Okay, game. I know. What is that? What's that woman doing? There we go. Ruining my screenshot. Leamington Spa. What does it say? Leamington Flyover. Pretty nice track. Station though. Some road underneath. Really nicely done. I guess this is one of the main stations on the route, so I put at least some decent amount of time on this station, making it look good. It's nice to see. Game, I know. Okay, we are about to pop the part soon, so mind the doors. Next stop, Banbury, platform 3. Right away, we are due to arrive in Banbury for a crew change at 7:18. I don't really want a crew change, I want to actually drive a train to, where are we going to? Southampton Central. Too loud in my opinion. You probably can't even hear me speak outside of the cab. What I'm planning on doing next is probably the return journey from Oxford Parkway to London Marylebone, like I did with the first video on the Chiltern Main Line. So we've already driven from Marylebone to Oxford Parkway as far as Beechester Village, but there's another scenario which goes back from Beechester Village towards London Marylebone, so that's what I probably will do next. And there's another one which goes from Birmingham Snow Hill to Marylebone, so I kind of want to do that as well, but it's quite long of a scenario. It's 110 minutes, which is almost 2 hours long, which is quite long. I'll probably do that in the weekend, most likely. I really want to do the Class 68 scenario, but do I really want to buy the Class 68? Then I have to install the reskin as well, which might or might not work. We'll see. I should have bought it when there was a sale on Steam. It's my fad. My bad. I should have realized that they would have added a Class 68 scenario with the Chiltern Main Line when I released the route, so it's my fault. I could could always just wait for the sale and then buy it and do the scenario for you guys. Miles left. Banbury is all the way there. No, that's where we are. And Banbury is all the way down there. Not too far away. Looks like a Chiltern Railways class, not class, three car train on platform 1. What was that, platform 4? Platform 1A. Interesting. Why is it called 1A and not just 1? That's interesting. So you got 1A, 2, 3. The three platforms. And Banbury is one of those one of the main stations on this route, so Banbury should look good in the game. I'm sure they put a lot of time and effort on the stations. Let's speed up a bit. Into a tunnel. Quite a small one though. If you want to play some of the scenarios that include with this route, then you will need to buy certain trains as well, because obviously this scenario uses a class 220 Voyager from Just Trains, so you will need to buy this from Just Trains to play this scenario on the Voyager line. And obviously if you want to play the class 68 scenario, you have to buy that on Steam. The reskin for the 68 is free of charge though, so you just have to buy the train. The class 166 and 165 you get with the Great Western Main Line, I believe. Which I'm pretty sure everyone has anyway. And there's scenarios with the class 20, I believe, which is you can buy from Just Trains as well. There's one with the class 66 or 67, I'm not too sure. I think it's the Just Trains one. I did check and I don't have it, so I'm guessing it's the Just Trains one. So I do own the class 66 and 67, I believe. I think I do. Oh, there's a... Oh, what am I doing? I'm not paying attention, guys. There was a 75 speed limit change and I'm still going at 90 miles an hour. Wow. My bad. This will happen when you don't pay attention. I actually thought that said 95 or something, but oh well. It's not a career mode scenario, so that's all good. We should definitely reach on time though now, because we were overspeeding by like at least 15-20 miles an hour through that section. is a class, there is a scenario with a class 170 London and livery, which is, I believe, a Birmingham stopper service. So that looks actually really interesting, so I might do that next. I actually might probably do that off next, then do the Marylebone return service scenario. Because I'm not a big fan of driving a class 166 or 165, so I'd rather drive a class 170 or 171 than a class 166 or 165. Like, the acceleration is so bad and the brakes are not the best either, so it's kind of like the class 450 on the Southwest Trains network. Great train, but horrible brakes, and I think the 450 does accelerate at a decent pace, I'm guessing. I haven't driven on a Southwest train route on Trains and Locomotives for a while, so might have to do that in the near future. Left. Our ETA is 7:15, and we should be reaching at 7:18, so we're quite early. We might get some speeding. We might get a red signal or a couple of double yellow signals or something like that, so we need to be careful. And all the scenarios that are included with this route are standard scenarios. They're not career mode, so if you do make a mistake, don't worry about it. You're not going to be scored on, and the scenario won't end straight away. You should go past the red signal. Almost at Banbury. Birmingham New Street to Southampton Central. Quite a long journey, actually. I think that's like a 2.5 to 3 hour journey. I actually feel sorry for the train driver that drives that journey every day. That is long, you know. It's like Milton Keynes Central to like East Croydon or something like that. Now, if you were driving Class 68 on that route, then fair enough. I really wouldn't mind driving Voyager in real life. It's a really nice train anyway. Nice cab. Maybe not the best brakes, but at least it can go fast. Unlike the class 166 and 165. I'm hoping when there's a stop at Banbury Station straight away and not make us wait until 7:17 at least, which you might do actually. So four miles left, then another driver will take over and take the train to Southampton Central. I believe you can disable a driver alarm, but I'm not too sure how. I'm guessing it's one of these ones. Most likely. Really attention to signals. I'm pretty sure we'll have a yellow signal soon. Or most likely a red, actually. Well, that's a slowdown now, actually. We've still got like 6 minutes to like reach there. There's only like two and a half miles left, so. Still got a green signal though, so that's interesting. But there is not much AI in this, in these scenarios, so. There will, I don't think there will be a train waiting at Banbury already, waiting for us to, obviously, if there was a train in front of us, then it would be at Banbury now and we would have to wait. Yeah, that's a green signal. Now, this route also has the track switcher, basically, you can switch between 2D and 3D tracks. I currently have it on 2D tracks. I believe 3D tracks will affect your FPS as well, so if you're struggling with FPS, then I wouldn't recommend going for 3D tracks. It's basically the same as the Western Main Lines, which is nice. You can switch between 2 and 3D tracks. When you do install the actual routes, then you'll get an application called Track Switcher, and essentially you can switch between 2D or 3D tracks. Whichever one you want. Almost there. Welcome to Banbury. There will be a short delay at Banbury while we change drivers. Actually, a really nice station, Banbury. Very nice. There we go. Slowing down. Are we gonna slow down in time? We should do. There's a stop there. I'll take that as well. That's fine. Shop. Not really though. Oh well. We got GWR train here, last 166. Do Great Western Railway stop here? I'm not too sure. I actually don't know. Maybe they do, I'm guessing. London to Birmingham for under £10. Really? I didn't realise that it was that cheap actually. I might just have to go to Birmingham myself for £10. I thought it'd be a lot more money. But yeah, welcome to Banbury. If you live in Banbury, let me know. Well done, driver. You did a good job on the service. Of course I did. Like I always do. Could be a lot of speeding twice, that's fine. But yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed that video. If you did, make sure you give it a like, share it with your friends, and I will see you in my next video. Bye guys.